We're out on court today to test the Deodora Speed Blue Shield Fly 2. Let's get started.
Wrapped up our play test of the Deodora Speed Blue Shield Fly 2 shoes. And now for me, I play tested the Speed 4 shoes a couple months ago, and the first thing I wanted to talk about was fit. Those were very wide shoes for me, and I have a narrow foot, and these Fly 2s fit a little bit more narrow for me. I'd say around a medium fit, so I didn't have a lot of extra room in the toe box or really anywhere in the shoe, which I appreciated. I was able to go straight down to the court. I didn't have any break-in. I was able to go right into points and match play. I did think the cushioning was more in line with what I would expect from Deodora's, a little bit more plush everywhere throughout the shoe, underfoot and around my ankle. I would say that the ventilation wasn't the best. We were play testing this in summer months and it was running a little bit hot for me. Michelle, how'd it work for you?
Yeah, these shoes actually worked really well as we play tested the original version of these, and I think we all agreed they kind of felt a little bit sloppy, and I think Deodora cinched up the fit with this update. And as Brittany mentioned, they are more narrow than the Speed 4 Blue Shield shoes from Deodora, but still fit on the wider side, but lots of cushioning, especially around the ankle collar. As Brittany mentioned, I had no break-in at all with these shoes either, but the first thing that I did notice was how squeaky the outsole was. So very squeaky. Sometimes I felt like it was me not picking up my feet. It hindered me a little bit mentally, but they were pretty loud at the beginning of the play test. Definitely dissipated as the time on the court went on. How did these shoes work for your feet, Tiffany?
Yeah, you know, the fit might have been a little bit narrower, but was still plenty wide for my foot. So I had no issues there, plenty of comfort right out of the box. I had no break-in. I too noticed that initially they were a little bit squeaky on the court as they settled in. I thought for me, the sound dissipated, as well as the traction initially was really sticky for me. And as I wore down the outsoles a little bit, I was getting a little bit more give, to the point where I was feeling a little bit quicker in and out of my shots, transitioning a little bit better. For me, where I wish that there was a little bit different laces on these shoes, the padding around the collar ankles was very comfortable, but it was a little bit difficult to cinch up for me as just the thinness of the laces.
Now, I'm always looking for shoes that offer a little bit more support and stability these days, and the first couple hits with this shoe, I definitely had a little bit of movement, especially around my ankle collar, and I was getting a little sore after my hits. When I looked at the shoes, I reevaluated and I saw that there was one more eyelet I could utilize, and so I did, and that was able to cinch up that ankle collar a little bit. So I wouldn't say the support and stability is high, but it was enough for me to get through my doubles matches without any issues. And I thought one of the highlights of the shoe was the weight. I felt very quick in the shoe and I was able to move around without any issue.
Yeah, I'd have to agree. They definitely aren't the most supportive option out there. However, I found the more that I wore these would be amazing for teaching pros that are spending hours of court time on their feet and looking for something super plush because they're so comfortable. Just for my personal use, I didn't love them in very aggressive moving situations.
Lastly, I wanted to touch on durability, and I was actually quite impressed for shoes of this weight. While they're not ultra lightweight, I thought they were on the lighter side, and the outsoles, after about 10 to 12 hours of hard court play, are showing very minimal wear. I am a toe dragger, and I have managed to scrape the top of the cosmetic. The silver is showing through, and I'm seeing white coming through, but the shoe itself is holding up really well underneath that. Overall, I think we found these to be a nice cushioned option and best for medium to wide feet. If you would like more information on these shoes or any others, please check us out at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.